सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Let's enter into today's sutra. I am continuing on Brahma Sutras. First chapter, first section, 17th sutra. Beta Vyapadesha Cha. Beta Vyapadesha Cha. Beta Vyapadesha Cha. Swami Gambhirananda translates this sutra as, and because of the assertion of the difference between the individual soul and Supreme Self, Swami Vireshwarananda translates as, on account of the declaration of difference between the two, the one referred to in the passage, the self consisting of bliss, etc., and the individual soul, the latter cannot be the one referred to in passage. Swami Shivananda translates as, on account of the declaration of the difference between the two, the one referred to in the passage, the self consisting of bliss, and the individual soul, the latter cannot be the one referred to in the passage. Beda Vyabadeshat Cha. There's a beautiful sutra in Taittri Upanishad. I wanted to bring it to your attention. And very beautifully, Swami Shivananda, Rishikesh Shivananda Swami. There were two Shivanandas very popular at the same time. One was in Kerala, Palakkad, Paramahamsa Shivananda. Another one was the Rishikesh Shivananda Paramahamsa, Shivananda Swami. So here I am referring to Swami Shivananda from Kerala. Sorry, from Rishikesh. Swami Shivananda from Rishikesh. He very beautifully refers. He is one of the great, very great Acharya of the modern days, one of the great architect of Hinduism. I can say some handful of people are responsible for what is known now as Hinduism being alive. Our yoga, Upanishads, Vedanta. If this is part of a common man's life today in the modern world, this handful of people are responsible. One is Ramakrishna and Vivekananda, naturally. And Maharishi Mahesh Yogi, Osho, Srila Prabhupada. I will say that in my experience, I'll put Swami Shivananda in that level. He is one of the great contributor to the Vedic tradition. He refers very beautifully. Actually, I am referring every day many of his collections and selections on Brahma Sutra. He has written a very beautiful commentary on Brahma Sutra. He has collected, culled out many of the beautiful Upanishads and references from various Aranyakas, various beautiful scriptures. Very authentically he has collected and translated. I wanted to remind you all, great Swami Satyananda Saraswati, one of the greatest yogi happened in the modern days, disciple of Shivananda Saraswati. I wanted to remember both of them and give them my humble respects. Because today what I am talking to you, all this technical information For me to collect and translate will take at least 10 years if I have to do all by myself. So lot of the technical work they all have done. So I wanted to give my gratitude and humble respects to those masters. If you read Swami Satyananda Saraswati's Yoga and Kriya book, whatever I am teaching in the morning Brahma Sutra, the Yoga Sutra, you will be able to catch it very easily. It will be very useful if you read that book. If you are regularly attending the Yoga Sutra Satsang. And same way, if you read Swami Shivananda's Brahma Sutra translation, it will really help you to grasp more whatever I am sharing in the Brahma Sutra Satsang. Because they have done an amazing work on the technical knowledge. To tell you honestly, I am not that strong in the technical knowledge. See, I am commenting on the authority of my spiritual experience, enlightenment. I am neither a Sanskrit scholar, nor English scholar, or scholar in the Upanishads or Vedas or the traditional literatures. I am telling you very honestly. Maybe if you are glamoured by me, enchanted by me, you will say, no, no, no. You know so much about scriptures and all that. But an honest social standard, there is a social standard if there is an examination about the scriptures, I can be 100% sure I will not take more than 30 marks. That's a maximum any normal teacher will give if they test my scriptural knowledge. I am commenting on the authority of my personal experience and the grace of my mentors, like a Raghupati Yogi, Kuppammal, Arasekki Swami, all these people. But the technical knowledge, these masters have done an amazing job. I wanted to recognize and put this on, I wanted to put this on record so that the posterity, the future knows their great contribution. I wanted to make it very clear, I never wanted at any time my organization to evolve as an independent cult built on me. It should always be rooted in the original Vedic tradition, the broad Vedic tradition, which is the source for Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, Vaishnava, Tantra. These are all different branches evolved out of Vedic tradition. You may be surprised, I mentioned even Hinduism as one name. Please understand, whatever you practice in the name of Hinduism, going to temples, rituals, anything, yoga, pranayam, all these things evolved from Vedic tradition. I wanted all of you to know, it is not Vedic tradition. It is from Vedic tradition. Just like Buddhism is from Vedic tradition, Sikhism is from Vedic tradition, Jainism is from Vedic tradition. The distance between the Vedic tradition and Buddhism, distance between Vedic tradition and Jainism, distance between Vedic tradition and Sikhism, distance between Vedic tradition and modern day Hinduism is equal. I wanted to make it very clear. It is equal. No way modern day Hinduism is closer to Vedic tradition than Jainism or Buddhism. So I wanted always our sampradaya to be the established and rooted in the broad Vedic tradition, which is the source of all these traditions, Shakta, Saiva, Vaishnava, all these great traditions. There is a beautiful reference by Swami Shivananda. रसो वैसह रसम हेव्या हेवायम लब्ध्वा नांदि भवती लब्ध्वा नांदि भवती। तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद सेकंड चैप्टर सेवंथ सूत्र If you don't understand, it's okay. I'm just putting it on record. But I'll translate and give you the complete meaning in course of the discourse. See, lot of the sacred secrets embedded in the sutra, you will be able to relate and understand if you have a little bit of background of the technical knowledge. How the truth is experienced and expressed and referred. Raso vaisaha rasam hevayam labdvanandi bhavati. That which is attainted and the attainer cannot be the same. Hence, individual soul is not referred to in the passage which is under discussion. I think here they have done a one printing mistake. It is supposed to be attained and the attainer. They have put one T extra, it became tainted and attainer. Anyhow, that's okay. Now let me enter into the sacred secret embedded in the sutra. The whole thing I can see boils down to pushing you towards the transcendental awareness happening in you. Constantly Vyasa Badarayana is getting you back to the transcendental awareness. If I have to reveal the sacred secret, if I have to reveal what I am going to talk for next half an hour, for example, you say, Swamiji, next half an hour I don't have time to sit, I have to run for the other work. Can you just tell me in one statement so that I can hear and run? I am going to say, get back to witnessing consciousness. That's all, which I am telling for last 10 years. This is the sacred secret in the sutra. Basically, Vyasa is basically trying to push you to the truth. Do not be satisfied in the space where the attainer retains even a scratch of individual identity. I have a big difficulty because first time these sutras are being taught to youngsters. Always these sutras were taught to some old buddhos who can't do anything further. Then Ramakrishna says, Brahma Sutra cannot be taught to the old people. Even if you teach, they will not catch it. Please understand, when I use the word here, Brahma Sutra, I use the word more like the process of awakening the inner space. Unfortunately, always it was taught to the old people. So almost their tiredness is taken as non-ego state. But first time, am talking about Brahma Sutras to youngsters. That is why so much of difficulty. Lot of difficulty because the modern day youngsters have to live continuously asserting their ego. Every moment the survival itself becomes ego based, you see. That is why even creation of the wealth, it is not creation, it is more like a grabbing. How much you can lie and cheat your boss and grab, that's all. It's all about grabbing. It has nothing to do with creation. In the modern day, the youngsters have to constantly be asserting their ego. But here, Brahma Sutra, constantly Vyasa is pushing to be centered on awareness. Actually, if you are centered on awareness, you will be able to create wealth out of creativity and have a deep satisfaction, fulfillment. But the big problem is almost your whole life has to be reshuffled. When you start living based on this sutra, which says that be established on the space the achiever and achieved is one and the same. Do not be in a space where the achiever and achieved are visibly felt as different, experientially felt as different. A continuous drive. See, if you are a yogi, for example, tomorrow many of you guys are taking up this vrata, Samyaman Chandra, 16 days. When you take up this kind of things and explore, basically you are a yogi. Your attitude is yogi. If you are a yogi, because of your everyday practices, all these ideas are constantly reminded to you. And the raising of the awareness has become an independent mechanism in your system. Every day, because constantly you remind yourself, you push yourself, even though one day you became low and angry, depressed. Next day you are up. You say, no. I'll stand, I will not fall. That re-establishing, I tell you, that is the greatest thing in the life. I had such a uncompassionate mentors and masters for me. I'm really happy. No, they will go on, you see. As far as the techniques and the spiritual knowledge, they are so compassionate. But they will never ever give me any support for my human weakness. You may be laughing, what? Swamiji had human weakness. When I use this word, I wanted to define it very clearly. It's like, oh, tomorrow we can do the practice. It's okay, these are all, tomorrow we can do, later on, no, I don't want to do meditation. This laziness, they never supported. And whenever the ideological difference problems, they never bent. They just stood strong.